Now, let's see how we can make dynamic programs using conditional jumping. By the end of this, we will have a program that differentiates between lowercase and uppercase characters, but first, let me explain the compare command. The compare command takes two values and sets different flags in the CPU. These flags can be used by conditional jump commands to skip or repeat pieces of code depending on the compare command's results. Here are six of these conditional jump commands. Each one uses the previous compare command's results, no matter how many instructions are between. JE jumps to the label if the two values compared are equal. JNE jumps if the values are not equal. JL jumps if the first value is less than the second. JLE jumps if the first value is less than or equal to the second. JG jumps if the first value is greater than the second. And JGE jumps if the first value is greater than or equal to the second. Now let's take a look at this program and break down each section. In the data section, we define the character we want to compare and three strings that we will use to show the program's results. Next, like always, we tell the program to start at the start label. Then we print the first message, as this will be displayed no matter the value of the character. We compare the value of the character to uppercase Z. Uppercase letters have a smaller value in ASCII than lowercase, so we know the character is uppercase if it is less than or equal to uppercase Z. Check out my short representing information using bits part 2 to learn about ASCII. Note that we are assuming that the character is a letter in the alphabet. Also note that we must specify the size of the value in memory. In this case, it is a byte because characters are represented by bytes. If the character is less than or equal to uppercase Z, we jump to the label named uppercase and move the address of the uppercase string into the register RSI. If the character was not less than or equal to uppercase Z, the program continues to the next line. I like to put a label there to match the format with the other label. Because the label is not needed, I create a comment that looks like the label. Comments are text in the code that are ignored by the computer. To create one, type a semicolon and then your comment, followed by a new line. Next, we move the address of the lowercase string into RSI and jump to the label named done. We jump because otherwise the program would continue to the next line and move the address of the uppercase string into RSI. Finally, we set up the registers for the write syscall, and fortunately for us, uppercase and lowercase are both 9 characters long. Finally, we exit the program with an exit code of 0.